Good evening, members of the Board of Directors, Alumni Board, distinguished viewers, seniors, faculty and staff, parents, family and friends. Welcome to the celebration of the Class of 2020 of Mount St. Joseph High School. We are conducting this ceremony to officially recognize the formal and successful completion of studies by this esteemed class from the Mount. Today is the formal culmination and recognition of so many blessings from the Class of 2020. It is my privilege to call forth Senior Kevin Protzman to lead us in prayer.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Heavenly Father, we thank you for the past 4 years we spent together as classmates, trusting that we will enjoy a lifetime of support as Mount Brothers. We thank you for our families who have sacrificed so much so that we could receive an education founded on Christian values. We thank you for the strength you have given us to endure the hardships we face today and the knowledge that that strength will lead us toward a bright future. In the years to come, Lord, we ask that you bless us with the compassion to always love everyone we encounter without exception, the humility to always celebrate the successes of those around us, the simplicity to always recognize what truly matters in our lives, the trust to always know that no burden is ever too heavy for us to bear, and the zeal to always be a source of light in the lives of those around us. St. Joseph, pray for us. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen.
It is my pleasure to introduce a gentleman and a scholar, Mr. Will Sykes, with his address to his Mount Brothers of the Class of 2020.
One of the easiest ways to begin a speech is to define a word. You pick a word to structure your speech around, preferably a broad, multidimensional word, like hope. Then you go to the dictionary and you copy down the official definition, which for hope is a feeling of expectation and a desire for a certain thing to happen. And by that definition of hope, I think we had all hoped for this year to end a little differently. I hoped to climb the tower before I graduated. I had hoped to be wearing a white tux today. But if the past 4 years were a speech, what word would you use to define them? Would it be a word to define the world-altering events of the last 3 months? Or would it instead be a word to define the memories, both good and bad, that you made here? While these last 3 months are far from the way I expected or had hoped my high school career would end, every second, every minute that I spent at MSJ is what I want to remember when I define my last 4 years. But I'm not going to stand here and define the past 4 years as perfect, because just like we as people are imperfect, St. Joe and my time there was imperfect too. But I think those imperfections, just like mine, helped me grow. And I think that's the best word for my personal experience, growth. By the end of the first month of freshman year, any Mount student could tell you that part of the mission of Mount St. Joe is growing boys into men who matter. And while some of you might smile and laugh at a phrase that at this point feels like a marketing slogan, I think it's true. When I look back at my freshman self, I was not the same person that I am today. Today, I'm bigger, I'm taller, I'm older, and I can actually grow some facial hair. But I've also grown as a person. I'm no longer a boy, and I'm on my way to becoming a man. And for most people outside of St. Joe that I know, their high school experience is mostly defined by the classes that they took. And I've honestly enjoyed most of my classes here. My teachers are legitimately good people, and they want nothing but the best for all of us. But more so than my teachers or my classes, my high school experience has been defined by you guys, my classmates. Anyone who plays a sport can tell you that your team becomes a second family, and that every teammate becomes a brother. And I think that's the best way to describe the connection that we all share. We are teammates in the game of life. From the chess games in the counseling center, to the after-school chem labs of Mr. Ader, to the heated debates in the basketball locker room, to being made to act in my English classes, Those are the experiences that define my last 4 years. But it's the experiences that I've shared with all of you. The IT workarounds, the football games, the jugs, the tests, the PSAT jokes, hot chocolate during midterms, the masses, Mr. Norton's honors assemblies, junior retreat. These are the experiences that bond us together. Even if we've never had a conversation, the experiences that we share define us and unite us. And it's because of these experiences that I know that you are a good person who will make the world better in some way, because you wouldn't have made it here otherwise. Traditionally, at the end of a speech, I would go back to a word that I defined earlier, and I'd summarize my thoughts. But life isn't a speech. For as difficult as it is to define the past 4 years, it's virtually impossible to define our future. Especially in light of what's happening around us, the future looks so wildly undefined. And I think that's okay. If you had asked freshman Will to pick a word to define what he thought his high school experience would be, he wouldn't have imagined that he'd pick growth. And I could tell you, if you asked me now to define the Joe itself in one word, I couldn't give you one. Because one word can't come close to describing all the things that St. Joe means to all of us. Because beyond the red bricks of Xavier Hall and the shiny floors of the Smith Center, I think Mount St. Joseph is best defined by the community of people. People from Miss Ursula and Jeffrey in the cafeteria, to Mr. Andrews and Mr. McDivitt in the administrative office, to each one of you guys, my brothers in the class of 2020. St. Joe is a community of people, people who look out for each other, who support each other, who push each other to succeed. And it's this community of people who has helped me define my past 4 years, and who will continue to help us define our future. Thank you.
I will ask the assistance of Mr. Robert Peace, our Director of Staff Formation, in the reading of the names of our seniors. By the authority vested in me by the State of Maryland, the Roman Catholic Archdiocese of Baltimore, and the Xaverian Brothers Sponsored Schools, Mount St. Joseph is proud to acknowledge the successful completion of studies of the following Mount students:
Matthew Francis Adams, Torin Woodrow Akins, Tony Lewis Akins, Michael McDonald Allen, Terrell Martinez Allen, Daniel John Ali, James Logan Anderson, Daniel Emerito Asuncion, Sean Anthony Bajadek, Christopher C. Barnaby, Gregory Alexander Wright Barnes, Brett Robert Bathurst, Kenneth Stanley Bauer III, Liam Joseph Bennett, Gannon Patterson Berry, Richard John Bestany, John Allen Blandimer, Donald Christopher Borum II, Matthew Cole Boylan, Tyler Christian Brelsford, Robert Christian Brown, Robert Paul Burr III, William Akawana Burchick, Colton Andrew Berger, Kyle Murphy Burke, Alexander Julian Burnett. Parker Raymond Bias. Brett Edward Callahan. Ryan Matthew Callahan. Cade Anthony Carbonero. Song Chen. Joshua Ahmad Cooley. Curtis Woodrow Cooper. Zachary Ryan Costantini. Matthew Anthony Cox. Alexander Christian Krabs. Patrick Paul DuBois. Nicholas Michael DeLauro. James Cody DeMaria. Matthew Raymond DeShong. Grant Matthew Hoon DeVivo. Aiden Taylor Dexter. Victor Sebastian DeMeo. Anthony Joseph DePino. Charles Vincent DePino. Andrew Neil Diver. Christopher William Dodd. Sean Patrick Donovan. Ian Daniel Dressman. Ryan Thomas Driscoll. Austin Reese Dulay. Robert Emmett Dunham IV. Jacob Ryan Dunn. Matthew William Easley. Jason Ifosa Idopai. Jonathan Sibong Ng. Michael Thomas Ennis. Reza Paul Farjami. Dylan Edward Fern. Connor Timothy Flynn. Liam Thomas Flynn. Nicholas Matthew Forgen. Ethan Webb Freeman. Alexander Sergey Furr. Raul Kumar Gundatra. Ryan Alexander Garner. Aiden Joseph Gavin. Quinn Thomas Gibbons. Patrick Colton Glynn. Max Burton Goff. Andrew Collins Goodman. Jordan J. Grace. Andrew Calvin Gray. Isaiah Malik Griffith. Nicholas Michael DeMarco Groff. Cameron Nazir Gidry. Amir J. Hall. Marshall Hassan Hall. Hassan Joshua Hammond. Charles John Hanlon. Aaron Scott Hartman. Michael Andrew Hash. Kai Deshaun Herbert. Donovan Alejandro Hernandez. Corey Martin Hicks Jr. Zachary Sean Holsey Simmons. Sean DeBrebeuf Brendan Hurley. Brennan Randolph Hyde. Ryan Karan Jaikaran. Noah T. Jarman. Leonard Lance Johnson Jr. Vaughn Christopher Johnson. Jordan Jackson Jones. Dimitri Joseph Jordan. Matthew Sung Jun. Jason Michael Kalanok. Daniel Joseph Kallmeyer. Christopher William Kelleher. Kalik Sky Keys. Thomas John Kippenbrock. Grant Joseph Klein. Connor Jason Cotula. Ryan Bennett Cron. William Ray Lasco. Nathaniel Rome Lathrum. James Hampton Lauer. James Christopher Lawrence Jr. Tyler Levon Levy. Lucas Anthony Lehrman. Christopher Thomas Lemke II. Patrick James Megan. James Elroy Mackle. Wilson Paul Manos. Michael Anthony Marsh II. Thomas Patrick Marshall. James Garrettson Mari. Christian Xavier McCormick. Benjamin Robert McElroy. Daniel Robert McManus. Matthew Christopher McManus. Garrett Paul Miller. Ryan Santiago Mills. Alexander Lucas Moeller. Brian Matthew Moran. Stephen Edward Morano Jr. Michael Joseph Lee Morrison. Braden Patrick Murphy. John Michael Nash. John William Nelson. Jaden Charles O'Keefe. Jordan James Oliver. Patrick James McEverett O'Toole. Robin Jose Perinillum. Kenneth Weaver O'Keefe. Parker Jr. Dylan Michael Parsons. Jonah Nicholas Peters. Peter Alexander Pittman. Michael Albert Plano. Joseph Stephen Plesser. James Edward Poling. Matthew Philip Ponatowski. Nathan M. Porter. Robert Allen Prender Jr. Kevin Wills Protzman. Arthur Graham Resch. Scott Michael Richter. William Charles Rispoli. Christopher Aaron Robinson. Garrett Scott Robinson. Charles Patrick Romeo. John Ryan Romiti. Christopher Lewis Roybal. Zachary Thomas Rosgani. Gabriel Michael Rupert. Ryan Andrew Rubinsky. Brian Meyer Repkowski. Cameron James Sapienza. Evan Michael Savarino. Joseph Daniel Shalmo. Shamar Lane C. Patrick James Selba Jr. Daniel Maurice Sherrod. Alexander Franklin Sims Jr. Robert Charles Skelton. Nathan Dennis Slutsky. Riley Augustine Smith. Dominic Joseph Snipes. Adam Joseph Snyder. Grant Timothy Susie. Grant Michael Steer. Connor Matthew Strong. William Anthony Sykes. John Warren Selankiewicz Jr. Hamza Talby. John Miles Thomas. John David Tiss. Riley Lonergan Toth. Sullivan Matthew Tao. Nicholas Paul Triplett. Devin Amir Truesdale. Zachary Ryan Euler. Brandon Ray Vaith. Michael Joseph William Vartain. Christopher Mark Wade Jr. Griffiths Scott Walker. Jacob Thomas Wallace. Benjamin Davis Walter. Liam Patrick Wands. Parker Samuel Warner. Marlo Eugene Wax Jr. Noah Joseph Weiss. Luke Jason Wheat. Caleb Paul Whalen. Zachary John Whelan. Nicholas Foster Williams. Nathan Charles Willis. Adam Joseph Wilson. Theodore Donald Wimberly Jr. Jack Joseph Weinman. Reed Otto Winter. Blake Matthew Wisnowskis. Austin James Fratar Wisniewski. Bradley Michael Wolf. Christian Kaiwen Wu. Colby Emmett Wood. Joseph Vincent Woody. Gabriel Marcus Wooten. Dylan Andrew Wyatt. Jeremy Angelo Yates. Anthony Zankin IV. Ladies and gentlemen, the class of 2020. The Brother Theodore James Ryken CFX Award, Excellence in Religious Studies, is awarded to Christopher William Dodd. The Bernd McDivitt Award, Excellence in English, is awarded to William Anthony Sykes. The Brother Henry Savage CFX Award, Excellence in Spanish, is awarded to Daniel John Ali. The Brother Joseph Glebus CFX Award, Excellence in French or Italian, is awarded to Ryan Bennett Cron for French and Stephen Edward Morano for Italian. The Brother Walter Dolan CFX Award, Excellence in Mathematics, is awarded to Robin Jose Paranillum and Christian Kaiwen Wu. The Dr. William L. Nell Award, Excellence in Science, is awarded to Curtis Woodrow Cooper and Robin Jose Paranillum. The Brother Vianney McDonald CFX Award, Excellence in Social Studies, is awarded to Curtis Woodrow Cooper. The Brother Isidore Kupel CFX Award, Excellence in Art, is awarded to Arthur Graham Resch. The Brother Peter Gaskin CFX Award, Excellence in Music, is awarded to Grant Matthew Hoon DeVivo and Robert Emmett Dunham IV. The Brother Conrad Callahan CFX Award, Excellence in Business, is awarded to Gannon Patterson Berry, James Cody DeMaria, and Griffiths Scott Walker. The Charles M. Connor Senior Award, Excellence in Computer Science, is awarded to Alexander Lucas Moeller. The St. Francis Xavier Award, Character, Leadership, and Scholarship, is awarded to James Cody DeMaria, Michael Albert Plano, and William Anthony Sykes. The Alumni Association Award, Extracurricular Achievement and Exceptional School Spirit, is awarded to Curtis Woodrow Cooper, Jason Ifosa Edopai, and Brennan Randolph Hyde. The Parents Club Award, Service to the School, is awarded to Max Burton Goff, Charles Patrick Romeo, and Jacob Thomas Wallace. The Brother Eugene Lyons CFX Award, Outstanding Gentleman, Scholar, and Athlete, is awarded to Daniel Maurice Sherrod, John Warren Solankiewicz Jr., and Theodore Donald Wimberly Jr. The Brother Donald Coffey CFX Award, Exceptional Commitment to Christian Service, is awarded to Donovan Alejandro Hernandez and Michael Joseph William Vartain and Zachary John Whelan. The John M. Plabiak Award, Mount St. Joseph's Outstanding Christian Gentleman, is awarded to Tyler Levon Levy, Nicholas Paul Triplett, and Marlo Eugene Wax Jr. The Brother Carlos Magruder CFX Award, Outstanding Dedication and Devotion to Mount St. Joseph, is awarded to Grant Matthew Hoon DeVivo and John Michael Nash. The John S. Connor Award, Academic Excellence, is awarded to Robin Jose Perinillo. The Judith A. Kraft Award, Involvement in the Life of Mount St. Joseph that Affirms the Importance of Enduring Personal Relationships, is awarded to Reza Paul Farjami, Isaiah Malik Griffith, and Stephen Edward Morano, Jr. The Brother James Kelly CFX Award, to the seniors whose understanding of Xaverian values characterized their Mount St. Joseph experience, is awarded to Daniel John Ali, Christopher William Dodd, and Parker Samuel Warner. The Brother Bernadine Ritters CFX Award, the Mount's highest honor, to the seniors who have given the most of themselves to make Mount St. Joseph an exceptional school, is awarded to Robin Jose Perinillum and Kevin Wills Protzman. Congratulations, gentlemen.
Good evening. 144 years after the Xaverian Brothers set up shop in Irvington, the class of 2020 moves on and goes out into the world to make a difference. We have been tremendously blessed with this class. They answer the call to raise the bar academically, spiritually, socially, artistically, and athletically. They may have been ultimately one of our most remembered groups ever to graduate, as we have focused on their accomplishments and noted their resilience, which is second to none. They learned reliance on their Mount Brothers with their achievements At times, they were knocked down, but they always got up stronger. The class of 2020 will be remembered by me as the class that fought back and handled adversity, earning significant college credit via their AP exams in their sophomore and junior years, with more to be acknowledged this July. A 90% pass rate, the best in school history. In the class of 2020, prior to this spring, they took 422 AP exams, scoring fours and fives on 242 exams. Also, by earning over $25 million in scholarships, with 65% earning awards, they accomplished much. In the math league, they dominated Baltimore City, County, and Catholic schools again this year, with a finance team finishing in the top 12 in the nation. Our marching band performed a show with the music from the Black Eyed Peas, and they provided pep music for football and hoops games, which generated that great, positive, wonderful Mount energy. An annual favorite, the Christmas concert, again, this year, put us in the Christmas spirit. Last fall, the show The Crucible, a show that features conflict, powerful performances in these trying times. In this society we live in today, that is confrontational, these young men have been trained differently to accept and try to understand people who disagree with them with an open mind and an open heart. They're very precise in their understanding of their strengths and weaknesses, and they know how to put their nose down and get the work done. They are ready for the transition to college, to the workforce, or to the military. While they didn't always win the championship, they always competed as a team, and they always fought back in every sport. Resilience marks this class. Soccer, volleyball, cross country, football, mountain biking, basketball, water polo, swimming, or wrestling. They were always in the mix for championships. The cross country team finished fourth in the state at the private school meet. The volleyball team lost in the playoffs, but I have more to say about them in a minute. The water polo team finished a best ever for the program, second in the league, and they accepted a bid to the Eastern Regionals, where they finished fourth. The soccer team finished ranked third by the Baltimore Sun in probably the most competitive soccer league in the nation. The football team lost against first place McDonough late in the season. And in speaking with them and the coaches as they came off the field, I told them, we'll get them in a month. As I looked in their eyes, I saw determination and confidence as they walked off the field. And indeed, a month later, in the final football game, the team came back, showing great resilience in defeating McDonough for the MIAA title, the first title outright earned at the Mount in football since 1949, and a ranking of 20th in the nation. 10-2 for the season, Mount resilience. The winter sports teams had tremendous success. Individual school records were set in swimming. The indoor track team suffered much illness this winter, but fought back to win the state title. When I inquired as to why some of the championship athletes weren't in the photo with the trophy, one athlete responded, "Mr. Andrews, I was so sick I left after my race as to not get the other guys sick." Mount resilience. The basketball team won the MIA title while defeating a top 10 ranked team twice out of four times this season. Mount resilience. The wrestling team overcame much adversity and sickness this season as we finished second in the MIAA because so many of our athletes were ill. But they took great pride in defeating McDonough for the state title at McDonough after McDonough had thought our guys had been beaten. Mount resilience. The hockey team won the MIA title, and the track team and the wrestling team have won state championships. The one thing in Baltimore that sets the Mount apart is our fans. The student section, supporting their Mount brothers. No school comes close. This leads me back to volleyball. While we didn't win the volleyball championship, I was thrilled that we fought back in a playoff game and the Smith Center was packed for our volleyball team, and the student section rocked the Smith Center. During the football championship at Spalding, no one will get me to believe that there weren't five Mount St. Joe students for every one from McDonough. The Mount students' energy clearly was felt on the field. And lastly, in the MIA hockey championship title game, as we shut out Spalding, and even our principal was caught on video jumping up and down with the chants. Hey, I couldn't help enjoying our crowd and our team on the ice. In their 4 years at the Mount, the class of 2020 has exemplified the brotherhood, and they have the requisite skills to make a difference in the community and a sense to help others. In the eyes of the Zavarian brothers, they see the Mount as a pillar of the Zavarian values, even though we're blessed with only one Zavarian brother in the school. The brothers sing the praises of what we accomplish as a school and in sending the students out in the world to make a difference. To the parents, you should be very proud of your sons for how they have grown, challenged themselves, and see a place of responsibility as they move forward. They grew out of the toughest challenges, and resilience was learned, and they will grow for it, and it will make them stronger. Maybe they have more resilience than we do as adults. High school is never easy. This last quarter was very tough on these seniors, but they made it through, and I know they will continue to excel. With great leadership, they excelled in service, won many championships, earned academic honors, and set a new standards for test scores. But we can be most proud of them looking out for each other. I want to thank the members of the class of 2020 for giving so much back to the school and enriching our community and exemplifying the Zavarian virtues of humility, simplicity, compassion, trust, and zeal. They have set such a high bar of excellence in the classroom with AP scores, scholarships, and in extracurricular activities. Please look out for your Mount brothers and make a difference in the world around you, as you've all been called to do by Theodore James Ryken, our founder, so many moons ago. Thank you, and God bless the class of 2020. It is my honor and privilege to call forth our retiring principal, Mr. David Lee Norton, from the class of 1971, to lead us in the singing of the alma mater.
I'm honored to be with you here at this ceremony. I'm honored to be singing the alma mater. If you are a graduate of Mount St. Joseph High School or a member of the class of 2020, I invite you to stand wherever you are, sing loudly so everyone can hear our alma mater. God bless the Mount St. Joseph community, and God bless the class of 2020.
To the class of 2020, we are extremely proud of all you've accomplished at your time at Mount St. Joseph. You have greatly enriched our school. It is time to go forth, carry on our great tradition, and continue to do the Lord's work. Know that you join some 16,500 Mount alums as brothers, a commitment that lasts a lifetime. Continue to make us proud in all that you do, and look after your Mount brothers. Today, you officially become Sons of the Mount. We pray daily at school events with a desire that all Mount men become the men God intends them to be. Attending Mount St. Joseph and graduating from this school is an important day in the lives of our students. As Theodore James Ryken would say, it is time to march on and make a difference in the world around you. As Mount graduates, you know you have gained brothers for life and that a diploma earned here lasts a lifetime and was built on the faith of generations of Zavarian brothers and on the faith and dedication of your teachers. For a final blessing, I'd like to introduce Father Mike Murphy, our chaplain from the class of 1982.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, may God bless you with restless discomfort about easy answers, half-truths, and superficial relationships, so that you may seek truth boldly and love deep within your heart. May God bless you with holy anger at injustice, oppression, and exploitation of people, so that you may tirelessly work for justice, freedom, and peace among all people. May God bless you with the gift of tears to shed for those who suffer from pain, rejection, starvation, or the loss of all that they cherish, so that you may reach out your hand to comfort them and to transform their pain into joy. May God bless you with enough foolishness to believe that you can really make a difference in this world, so that you're able with God's grace to do what others claim cannot be done. May God bless you with discomfort in easy answers and half-truths and superficial relationships, so that you may live deeply within your hearts, always and at all times. And may Almighty God bless you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.